All right, so a couple of my favorite exercises. I'm going to show you pretty simple. I have like a lot of different exercises, but for the sake of the video, we're going to keep it short and sweet, and I'll explain why I like these certain exercises. So some of my favorite exercises are actually at a gym, specifically the hamstring curl machine, specifically the one where you lay down. It really gets a lot of it gets a really good pump into the hamstring, so I do that a lot. A lot of heavy weight, lots of volume, a lot of pumping blood into the hamstring curl. And then I also like the Nordic exercise, which I don't, again, you need a machine for that. You're gonna use a GHD machine. Put you lock your legs in, you fall slowly forward, and you come back up. I made a YouTube video talking about jujitsu and exercises to help you with jujitsu, for example, or wrestling or soccer or football or anything that is a kind of very demanding sport. Hockey is another good example. You need strong hamstrings so that you don't hurt yourself. Actually, even do the Nordic exercise with weight. I actually just hold a dumbbell and I just fall and I come up slowly. You want to get to a point where you can fall slowly and come back out without using your hands. So I can do that, but a lot of people can't do that. So you can start from a surface where you stop yourself at a bench or something, and you push yourself away and do that for reps. All right, my next favorite exercise are rear delt flies. Nice thing about rear delt flies with dumbbells is that you can use different angles with depending on how you place your hand. Rear delts are really important, and I think a lot of people neglect them often. You train them in your back training when you're doing rows or you're doing lat pull downs, but I think directly training them is really important. So I do a lot of rear flies. So you start here, your delt fly, slowly come back down. These are only 10 pounds. Sometimes I'll use a lighter weight and we'll rear delt, hold it for about 2 seconds, slowly come back down and do that for sets of, 50 or what have you. There's a machine at the gym that you can use. It's the pec deck machine where you sit and you rear delt fly that way. I do those a lot, but doing the dumbbell works just fine. But I really like the rear delt. Helps to get the back part of the delts, which are your shoulders. Your shoulders have three heads, front, lateral, rear. So you wanna make sure you're hitting all those different angles. Right, so my next favorite exercise is the safety squat bar lunges. You can use anything where it front loads your body to put more stress on the glutes. You'll notice if you use the safety squat bar and you lunge with it, you're gonna feel a little bit more stress on the glutes. And that's because of the angle in which the pressure is putting on your body, and just a kind of a basic physics thing. I do a lunge. A lot of people will tend to lunge forward. That gets more glutes. So right now I'm targeting my left leg is in front, and I'm targeting my left glute. This is also a knees over toes exercise. Really good for the knees. You probably know someone on Instagram that's known for this, but it's a simple knee lunge. More knee focus, and it helps to strengthen the teardrop, the quadricep, but also the glutes. Okay, so this is one of my favorites exercises. You can use two dumbbells in the hand. You can use a dumbbell here or a barbell here. This is the safety squat bar. This is what it looks like. Simple lunge forward, back up, lunge forward, back up. I also will do this on a bench, so I'll lunge down, back up. My foot is on the bench, pretending to be on bench. But you'll notice that when I lunge down, right now my left knee is on the floor, and I'm not lunging this way, straight up and down. I'm lunging down, forward. So down, forward, back up. Down, forward, back up. You'll notice if you lean forward, you're gonna feel it here in the glutes and a lot in the hamstring. because there's a lot of pressure here, also in your inner thighs. Now the weight is more pushing me more forward, so I have to use more of my glutes to control the weight. So I said earlier though, you can do squats with these. Safety bar squats are a great exercise to do with close stance squats. So close stance, safety squat bar squats. Some people go really wide and squat that way. Some people go kind of medium. I tend to go about hip width apart, shoulder width apart, whatever is comfortable for me on that day. But safety bar squats, one of my favorite exercises. My next favorite exercise is a quadruped bird dog row. It's really good to strengthen the erector spinae and your abdominals. If you have some sort of imbalance in the core musculature, this is a really good exercise to give it a try. And your right leg, your left arm, come in, extend. So I'm gonna lift my left leg. I'm gonna use my opposite arm and I'm gonna row to my hip and back down. This is obviously a really light weight, but you choose a heavy-ish weight and it should throw you off balance and it should allow you to practice how to use your core and your center of mass to avoid resisting or to avoid rotating too much as you row with the exercise. The nice thing about this is that you can do it in this dimension. You can also do it in this row, a metal type of row. And then you can also row in front of you, keeping that leg again up as you row in front or vertical. The last exercise I will show you that is one of my favorites is, although every exercise is really my favorite, but these are just some of the things that I think are often overlooked. I'm going to lay down, and this is a dumbbell pullover, really good for the lats. You're gonna take a heavy-ish dumbbell and you're going to pull it behind by your ears and slowly come back up. When I am down here, I'm using all of these muscles in my back to resist the force. And I'm going to come back up right above my chest, okay? You can also get creative. You can combine it with abdominal exercises. So you are here, you extend, come back in, extend, come back in. Okay, if you want to get more creative, you can do dead bug type of position. Really gets, again, the lats and the chest. When you pull back, you can put your feet here or here. Pull back. Right now I'm using a lot of back and chest as I come up. I like to use a heavier weight, generally at least 50 upwards to 80 pounds depending on the day. Those are the exercises I picked to show in this video. I purposely picked exercises that I think are often overlooked and people don't really often do. People don't really think about their rear delts. They don't think about creative exercises to work them in different dimensions because your body, we are three-dimensional creatures, so you want to work your body in different dimensions. You have a frontal plane motion, sagittal, and transverse. Transverse is rotation, sagittal is right or forward and back, frontal is left to right. So you want to work your body in different ways to not only have a nice body, but to also have a functioning and healthy physique so that you can do things in your life that you probably wouldn't have thought of doing because you didn't train a certain way. Now, the more funky exercises like the quadruped bird dog row, you can count that as technically of an ab exercise. So you can put it towards the end of your training after you do any sort of strenuous activity like cardio, or you do your heavy weight training, or, you know, your bodybuilding type of day. You can save the quadruped dog rows after, towards the end when you're finishing up, just as a way of kind of therapy and a way to maintain symmetry in your performance and in your physique. Consider liking the video if this did help you, and leave a comment below with any questions and comments that you may have. And for your program, you can always email me and check me out on my other social pages for a custom program or nutrition protocol. I would be glad to help you on that, and I will see you in the next video.